Welcome to Vault 112, Resident. According to sensors, you have arrived 202.3 years behind schedule. Please redress in your Vault Tech issued Vault suit before proceeding. If you have misplaced your suit, I am authorized to distribute a new one. Once dressed, please proceed down the stairs to the main floor so that you may enter your assigned Tranquility Lounger. A Tranquility Lounger is available. Please be seated.
You shouldn't be here, little one. Betty, you need to talk to Betty. She's waiting for you.
What can I do for you, sport? Betty? Well, she's Betty, you know. You really shouldn't keep her waiting.
Say, Martha, how are you today? Oh, I was just looking at the new Robco catalog. Some impressive things they're doing these days. Later. Hello. Good day. Good day to you. No, I haven't. But when I do, I'll tell him you're looking for him. Hello.
Hello.
Good day.
Hello. Good day.
Not real.
Hi. Oh, someone new to play with. What good luck I have lately. I was just starting to get bored. Oh, we're going to have so much fun. I'm Betty. I live here on Tranquility Lane. Want to play a game? I knew you would. It's a really simple game. All you have to do is make Timmy Newsbum cry. He's the only other kid that lives here besides you. He's a big crybaby. You'll see. Make him cry, and then come back here so we can talk some more. You're supposed to be making Timmy cry. You can do it. I know you can. When you win the game, maybe we can talk some more. Oh, don't worry about that now. There are things to do. Tell
Good day.
Good day. Why don't you look where you're going?
You don't belong here. You're not supposed to be here. It's not real, none of it. It needs to end. We're not really here. We're not really talking. It's all made up, make-believe. We're sleeping, dreaming. The dream became a nightmare. It has to end. It just has to. But we're not in charge. He is. And he doesn't want us to wake up. He calls himself Betty now, but he's still the same. He can put on a new face all he likes, but underneath he's still evil. Braun. Bastard thinks because he helped create this place he's God here. But I know he still uses the fail-safe terminal. I know it. It's in the abandoned house. He doesn't want us going in there because he's afraid we might find it. It's the only terminal to the outside. The only way to shut the whole thing down. You've got to find it.
shoot! She wants to-
What you've done! You've triggered the failsafe! Ruined everything! The subjects will die and I'll be stuck here in this hell alone!
You ruined everything! Everything!
You've taken them all from me! You've left me with nothing!
It's not fair! Nobody to play with ever again.
Hello, sir.
Son, you've saved me. I was afraid I'd be trapped in there forever. It's so good to see you, but what are you doing here? Well, I'm glad you did. This certainly wasn't how I expected things to turn out. I wasn't ready for Brawn, or I might have fared better. It certainly is. It's nice to feel that I'm on two legs again. And thanks to Dr. Brawn, I know that Project Purity isn't lost after all. I was right about Brawn. The technology he developed is unstable, even dangerous. But it can be adapted for Project Purity. I need to return to Rivet City and talk with Madison. If we can find a Geck, we can make Project Purity work. Yes, with what I've learned, Madison is sure to see that we can finally succeed where we failed so many years ago. I'd like you to come with me. I'd like you to be there when we finally open the floodgates. That's my boy. Let's hurry. Now that I know what we need, I want to get back to work as soon as possible. Be careful, my son.